My dear children, welcome to the EVS online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. I am Jinisha, your EVS teacher. How is it going? Hope you all are safe at home. How was your assessment? Hope you all have written the assessment very well. Before your exam, we have started a new lesson from our semester 2 textbook. Do you remember? What is the name of that lesson? Yes, lesson 1, Food and Digestion. We studied about the different types of nutrients which are needed for the proper functioning of our body. Which are the different types of nutrients? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. We also discussed about the functions of each type of nutrient. Also, we studied that roughage and water are also very important for the proper functioning of the body. Then we studied about balanced diet. What is a balanced diet? A diet that contains all the nutrients in the right quantities is called a balanced diet. We know that all the nutrients are not together present in the same food. So to get all the nutrients in the correct quantities, we have to include different types of food in our diet. Today let's discuss about digestion. What is digestion? You have studied this in your third standard. Yes, digestion is the process of breaking down of food into smaller, simpler substances to be used by the body. We need food to get energy for all our life activities. But we cannot directly use the food that we are eating to get energy. So the food has to be broken down into smaller, simpler substances to be used by the body. This process of breaking down of food into simpler substances inside the body is called digestion. Digestion takes place in a number of steps with the help of different organs of our body. These organs together form a digestive system. So, digestive system is an organ system that helps in the digestion of food. This is a model of digestive system. Digestive system consists of mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. Also, there are three glands associated with this. They are salivary glands in the mouth, liver and pancreas. All these organs together form the digestive system. Now let us see what happens to the food when we eat it. Food is taken into the body through the mouth. Inside the mouth, what happens? Yes, teeth breaks down the food into smaller pieces by chewing. Salivary glands inside the mouth produce saliva. The tongue helps to mix the food with the saliva so that it can be swallowed easily. Saliva also helps in the breakdown of starch into sugars. We studied that starch and sugar are two types of carbohydrates. In the mouth, saliva breaks down starch into sugars. So the digestion of carbohydrate starts in the mouth. Then food passes through the esophagus and reaches the stomach. Stomach is a bag-like organ. Inside the stomach, certain digestive juices are produced. These digestive juices break down proteins and fats into simpler substances. Food remains in the stomach for up to 3 hours. Then food passes to the small intestine. Small intestine is a long coiled tube. The walls of small intestine produce certain digestive juices. Also, liver and pancreas produce digestive juices which reach the small intestine. So, all these digestive juices break down food into simpler substances. And digestion is completed here. So, the digestion is completed in the small intestine. The digested food is now in a simple soluble form. The walls of small intestine has blood vessels. The blood absorbs this digested food through the walls of small intestine, and the blood takes the food to different parts of the body. Energy is produced from this digested food. Some part of the food cannot be digested by our body. So the undigested food then passes into large intestine. Here, absorption of water occurs. Water from the undigested food is absorbed in the large intestine. Then the remaining solid waste is removed from the body through an opening called anus. So this is about digestion of food. Digestion starts in the mouth. Food is taken into the body through the mouth. Inside the mouth, the teeth breaks down the food into smaller pieces. Salivary glands produce saliva. Tongue helps to mix the food with the saliva. Saliva breaks down starch into sugars. Then food passes through esophagus and reaches the stomach. Inside the stomach, proteins and fats are broken down into simpler substances. Then food reaches the small intestine. Digestion is completed in the small intestine. The digested food is absorbed by the blood through the walls of small intestine. Blood takes the food to all parts of the body, and energy is produced from the digested food. The undigested food passes into the large intestine. Here, absorption of water occurs. The remaining solid waste is removed from the body through an opening called anus. So today we have discussed about digestive system and the process of digestion. Read textbook page number 5 and 6. Hope you all have completed writing the notes of this lesson. From notebook, study question number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 from fill in the blanks. Question number 5 from name the following. And question number 6 from answer the following. You can also make a model of digestive system like this. A YouTube URL is attached along with this. Watch the video. A test paper is also attached. Do the test and submit it. So let's meet in the next class. Thank you.